Do you know how you can use Slider in powerapps? Hi, this is Krupali from Know How Academy. So let's start with me. So let's see what we are going to see in this video. Let me run the app save and run the app first so I can show you. Now this is the website, or you can say this is the application page where I'm displaying the data of product. Now this is the slider. Now I have set the slider value, minimum value 550 and maximum value is 2000. Now when I change the slider value, when I'm changing the slider value, according to that my gallery will filter the data, or my gallery will contain data based on given condition. So let's say my minimum value is 500 and let's say my maximum value is 834. So it will show only the product which price is greater than or equal to 550 and less or equal to 838. Now let's say if I change it to 1000, okay? Now it will display the data which price is greater than 550 and less than 1100. Okay, so how we can do that? So let's design the same screen for that. Okay, so I'm taking one blank screen. Now I have already a product table which contains the data of the product name, product brand, product price and its color, and also image is also there. Now let me design a screen like this, this heading, then gallery control and filter. So my screen is ready, which will display the product information, that is product image, product name and product price. Now what I need to do, I need to add a slider control to change the price based on whatever the selection. So for that, I need to search for slider. Okay, slider. And here it will come. And here I will put the label. Select the price range. Okay, and slider has a property called max value and min value. So by default 0 is the minimum value and 100 is the maximum value. So let me change the maximum value. Let's say my product has a maximum price 2500 and my minimum price is 550. Okay, and then let me change the slider price. Okay, let me change the name of the slider, that is slider price N. Now what I need to do, when I change the slider value, gallery control will filter data according to the value of the slider. Now let's say, let me run and save. Okay, now say what is the minimum value, you can see when you put your cursor on that, and when you change it, the slider value is changing and it will move to till 2500. Now one property of the slider is slider name dot value. It will give the current value. Okay, now see my current value is 1576. Okay, so for that I need to get the current value of the slider as well as the minimum value of the slider, and I need to filter data according to that based on the gallery. So in gallery, from an item property, I need to use the filter function. So filter function will filter the data based on some specific condition. There is not that you can provide only one condition, you can provide n number of conditions based on your requirement. So here I need to provide two conditions. One condition is that a price should be greater than the minimum value and less than the current value of the slider. So how can I write that? So filter and you need to write the first the data source, that is from the product table. Then what I want to do, so I want to filter the price, so select the column and it should be greater than or equal to slider price dot minimum value and price should be less than or equal to slider price dot value. Dot value will give the current value. Okay, then complete the bracket and save and run it. Now let's say I'm putting the slider value, let's say this, so it will display the data which is there 550 560, that is between the AMC 550 and 860. Okay, now if I change the slider value, you can see the data in the gallery control according to that. If I increase the value, data will change according to that, and if I decrease the value, data will change according to that. Now let's say let me put the current value and the minimum and the maximum value so we can get easily the idea. Okay, that is minimum value here I can display here, slider price dot min. Okay, so minimum is that, and here I need to see the value of the current slider, current value of the slider, so I am selecting the price. Okay, now let me change, see 501,460. Okay, so you can do the filter using a slider based on the given condition. I hope you understand. Thank you for choosing Know-How Academy as a source of your IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate to the tech world. Do not feel hesitant to reach out to us. Stay curious and keep learning.